I mean, I even put it on my, you know, 10-ounce silver bar. You know, real friends, real skills, real wealth. That's the three places, you know, I want to invest in. You know, you want to have real friends, because I think it's going to be very important to have people who you can trust, you know, on a really deep basis, not this Facebook friends like, oh, I have, you know, 1,000 friends on Facebook or something like that. I mean, like the 2 or 3 people who you can really count on to stay with you during those, you know, tough times. I think that's important. Real skills. I mean, let's face it, you know, after things hit the fan, you're still going to have to live. You're still going to have to create value. And unfortunately, I think the majority of Americans, because that's mostly our audience, have no real skills. I mean, they push paper around, they do stuff on computers, but they don't produce any real tangible value to humanity. And, you know, unfortunately, the people who do provide real tangible value really don't make a lot of money. It's not sexy. And, you know, there's not a lot of, you know, money or fame to be had. And yet, you know, we got all these young kids who are, you know, going off to college, getting worthless degrees, or you know, chasing after, you know, fame and Hollywood, Wall Street, you know, working for government, bowing down to the Clintons or the Bushes or whatever. They don't produce any real value. And I think that the people who can create, you know, real wealth and skills and attune to their passions are going to come out a lot better, even if they don't have friends, even if they don't have wealth. You know, work on the skills, do something that creates value. And then, you know, like Andy said, with wealth, this is not something to be trading, hedging, you know, think that you're going to make a quick buck. You know, your wealth needs to be measured in ounces, calories, rounds, you know, real tangible things that you use that matter. And, you know, and I try to tell people, you know, stop worrying about dollar profit losses. You know, oh, I bought here, I didn't get there, I'm going to sell at this. No. This is a matter of getting as much real tangible wealth outside of the system and hopefully have you enough sense and awareness to get through to the other side. Because, you know, like Andy said, you know, once we get to the other side, some other financial paradigm is going to come up, whether it's, you know, some Bitcoin, you know, demon, you know, Satan currency that the government instills upon everybody to get their paychecks in the inner cities and stuff like that. Or, you know, we have a lot of these big gold and all these other, you know, alternative currencies. There isn't anybody in the world, any system in the world that's not tangible that I would trust with the system. You know, we talked about this bit gold and stuff. I like all these guys, but, you know, and good on you. But ahead of the world's largest global Ponzi scheme collapse, where, you know, nations' currencies backed up by nukes, oil, you know, bureaucracies, this generational consciousness are going to fail. You think, like, you know, any of these bit anything is going to last it, you're insane. You got to stick to the stuff that works, you know, gold and silver. And certainly, you know, get your food together. I mean, I have, I don't know how many years of, and I'm not looking forward to eating any of it, but storable food and stuff like that. But, you know, you got to be prepared.